just present this. You can take a screenshot and then write it in your communicative English books.
This call is now being recorded.
Okay. So as I told you, you can take this down. You take down the screenshot and learn these new words. Write them in your. You can take the screenshots, write them in your communicative English pair books. So first, you know, we do some advanced words related to COVID. Still now, I made this, I think in the month of May or something. So till now, there are some more new words which I haven't yet made. But at that time, whatever were the advanced words, I have tried to share with you all. So first is variant. Okay. If we get time, after this, we'll do something else. But just we'll quickly go through this. Okay, I want one of the children to please read this. Girl. Yes, Rupani. Yes, Rupani. Yes, Rupani. One second. Rupani Zainab, listen to me better.
Yes, ma'am.
Rupani, read this. After this, you are going to take one girl. And no, after to read the thing, okay? Then you are going to be the captain for today. So every time we one finishes, we have to select the next call. Okay? So that there is no confusion. So Rupani is in it, you can start with this.
Okay.
Start reading.
Okay. Variants.
And what are these ones? What are these are advanced words related to COVID-11. Okay? Yes, variants. Yes, with the beginning.
Variance, number one, a form of a version of something that differs in some respects from other forms of the something or form, a standard clinically distinct variance of malaria. Number two, varying usually slightly from the standard from variant.
Your voice is cut.
Readings. Number three.
It's breaking. Varying usually slightly from. Yes, better now.
Varying usually slightly from the standard from variant readings. Number three, obsolete, variable. Example, a variant from variant form of a virus made traditional methods of treatment ineffective.
Okay. Now let me explain. Variant is again another form of a variant. Okay. A form of version of something that differs in some respects or other form of the same time or from a standard clinically distinct variant of malaria. So from these, you know, there are different viruses. From one version, it is there are many more versions coming out. So clinically distinct variants of malaria. So variants are what? Again, they are a type of a virus. Okay. Varying usually slightly from the standard form variant readings. So what we learned in the COVID-19, okay, from that it'll be slightly different, not much, much difference, but slightly different. So you can say, no, you must have heard, or you must have heard the news, or you must have read in the newspaper, or you must have heard somebody speaking. Now I have heard that a new variant has come and it is affecting people. So just like coronavirus, you know, like the new coronavirus, because some 10 years back there was another coronavirus, but since after this last year when the coronavirus appeared, you know, they couldn't name it because it was slightly like the same corona that happened 10 years back, but they didn't know how to name it, so just they kept it the novel coronavirus. Now again, this again is a part of the same thing, like malaria, like sort of a malaria variant. And we say that, you know, a new variant has come which is affecting the eyes or the nose or whatever, or a new variant has come which is like slightly like the coronavirus, but the symptoms are different. So variant is also a form of a virus. Okay. Now, obsolete means variable. Obsolete, variable. Example, a variant form of the virus made traditional method of treatment ineffective. Now, let me explain. Obsolete also means something that is not in use anymore. But, you know, here, look at the example. This is just the meaning of obsolete. Example, a variant form of virus made traditional methods of treatment ineffective. That is, there is a treatment for virus, but that is the traditional, the old method of treatment. Now they are saying that the variant form of the virus made traditional methods of treatment ineffective. So the old method is not at all effective. It is ineffective. That is the meaning of the sentence. Now, Rupani Zainab, select one girl and shall I ask her to read?
Okay.
Select a girl, beta. Rupani Zainab. You can see the names, no? Because I'm sitting separate, I cannot see. If I go back again, my screen has to be removed to see who is present.
Yes.
Tell me the name of a girl, beta. Name the girl who's going to read this. Zainab, why is it taking so long, beta?
Mother Sanayani, can you read?
Mother Sanayani, please read. Just say ma'am, the name. No need to say, can you read?
Okay.
Mother Sanayani? Nayani Mother Sir? Mother Sanayani? Okay, call out another girl's name.
Anam Fatima Burani.
Anam Fatima? Anam Fatima?
Yes, ma'am.
Please read the strains.
Okay. Strains first is an act of straining or the condition of being strained, such as a bodily injury from excessive tension and effort. Second, a strain according to a report is a variant that is built differently, shows different physical properties and behaves differently than its parent virus. These behavioral differences can be subtle or obvious. Coronavirus, like the acute respiratory
syndrome. One second. Why has it come like this? Okay. Now it's become yes, please read.
Coronavirus is like the severe acute respiratory syndrome. Coronavirus 2 is now one among a handful of other well-known strains in the coronavirus family. Instinctively, the SARS and MERS virus.
Actually, it MERS is including, but the spelling is wrong. So, including the SARS and the MERS virus. Okay. So, let me explain. It is an act. Please mute your mic, girls. So, it is an act of streaming. Or the condition of being strained, such as somebody's mic is unmute, girls. Okay, it is an act of straining or condition of being strained, such as bodily injury from excessive tension or effort. For example, you strain yourself too much. Suppose you are cleaning the house, you've decided to clean the house, just one room, and then you clean the room and you're tired, but you know, feel that, no, let me complete the second one also. So even in spite of being very tired, you complete the other room also, you know, cleaning, the taking out the cobwebs, cleaning the windows, dusting the things, everything around, furniture, changing the bed sheets and all that. So You are straining yourself. In spite of being tired, you are straining yourself. So strain is actually straining yourself. Okay, there are two meanings that to that. One is straining, like yeah, such as a bodily injury from excessive tension and effort. So when you put on a lot of effort or there is a lot of tension, for example, you are studying for your exams and you study, keep on studying, studying the whole day. And obviously, you know, you get tired. So your mother says, don't overstrain yourself. So that is one meaning of strain. But the other meaning of strain is, a strain according to report is a variant. So just like we learned the variant in the first one, okay, it is also a variant, but that is built differently, shows different physical properties. So as you know, all the disease that you learn about has some other virus or bacteria with which it happens. So in the same way, strain is a part of any disease or a variant. It's just the same. Meaning is same. Variant and strain is same, okay? Is a variant that built differently, shows different physical properties and behaves differently than its parent virus. So, for example, we know that if you got the coronavirus strain or the strains of coronavirus, the symptoms will be such, you all know. But you know that the second that came out, you know, about the fungus eye, the yellow eye, again, it is a strain. It is a part of that, but the symptoms will be different. It will affect a different part of the body. So it is a strain, it's just a part of it, okay? And these behavioral differences can be subtle or obvious. So it is very obvious by the symptoms that you have. So in coronavirus, you have certain symptoms like fatigue, fever, your tastelessness, you don't get any smell, your legs pain, all this happens. But when you talk about the yellow fever, the yellow fungus and the, you know, that came off after that. So the yellow fungus and the whatever two or three funguses that came, it was usually affecting the brain and the eyes. So it is a strain of the coronavirus, but the symptoms are different. Okay. So like the severe acute respiratory syndrome, coronavirus 2. So, you know, the short form is SARS-CoV-2. So what are the symptoms, you know, you all know of corona, is now one among the other handful well-known strains in coronavirus family. So all these are part of the member of the coronavirus, but each has a different effect. So another one is of the family of the coronavirus is MERS, Middle East Respiratory Syndrome. So here it affects the respiratory syndrome. Girls, are you listening or not? Girls?
Yes.
Okay, so you learned two words today. You learned variant and you learned strains. Actually, I wanted to take this in the beginning itself, but somehow I couldn't do it. So let's, I want the third girl to read better. Jivani, Tena, please call out the third girl's name.
Sakina Madhvani.
Sakina Madhvani. Madhvani Sakina. Madhvani Sakina. Madhvani Sakina. Madhvani Sakina. Beta, you'll have to learn this whether you like it or you don't. Because you have to learn new words to enrich your vocabulary and you should know what is happening around. Madhvani Sakina. Okay, call out another name, Zainab. I'll write down the names of those who are not answering. One is Madhvani Sakina, and who was the other girl who didn't answer?
Madhya Sanayan,
the two girls. Please remember the names and I write them down also. Next, okay, call out the Sakina. Third name.
Sakina Ghabrani.
Ghabrani Sakina.
Yes, ma'am.
Please read this.
Yes, ma'am.
Please read this letter.
Okay, ma'am. Mutate. Number first. Change in form of nature. Number two. In biology, it means to undergo or course to undergo change in
gene.
Change in gene or genes.
That is
to alter something
that is okay. IE is a short form of that is okay.
That is to alter something that develop different characteristics. As a result of change in the genes. Example, once a virus gets into your body, usually through your mouth or nose,
it latches onto
one of your cells, where it can make copies of itself that go off and affect other cells. If the virus can copy itself and hijack another of your cells, of your cells without being wiped out by your immunity system, that show you fall sick.
Okay, thank you, Beta. So let me explain mutate. You know, mutate is meaning is change in form or nature. Okay, in biology, it means to undergo a course to undergo change in your gene or genes. That is to alter something that develop different characters as a result of the change in the genes. That means mutate means a change. Okay. So here in biology, it means to undergo a cause or undergo change in the gene. So all of you all have your ancestors, your parents, your grandparents, your uncle, aunties' genes in you. Okay, you would have heard your mommy say that, like suppose you are very good at something. For example, you are very good at cutting vegetables, you know, and you keep them very neatly and nicely, or you good at decorating. So your mother will immediately say, no. My God, you are just like your grandma. She was just perfect like you. So you've got your grandma's genes in you. Okay. But here we are talking about the health issues. Okay. Here we are talking that the characteristics of the genes will change. So example, once a virus gets into your body, usually through your mouth or nose, it latches on to one of your cells, where it can make copies of itself that go off and infect other cells. That is, here it shows that if you're infected by something, like just as our genes work in our body, even the virus works in our body like that. So if you get infected, you know, say by coronavirus, you know, the cells of the coronavirus keep on multiplying. That is, they keep on growing. You know, same type of genes, they keep the infection started in all the cells. So if the virus can copy that self and hijack enough of your cells without being wiped out by your immunity system, that's how you fall sick. That means if you have got coronavirus or you've got some virus, now the cells of the virus keep on multiplying in your body. And because of the multiplication of these cells, what happens? It affects all the organs of your body. And that is why you fall sick. So if it doesn't multiply, maybe, and if you take some medication, you might, you know, you might be all right within a day or two. But because of the multiplication of the cells, that is growing, that is mutation, okay, understood? So mutation of the cells in your body, what happens? You fall sick. I hope you're understanding what I'm trying to say. Next is very small. So Zainab, you read this, just read this. Zainab?
Okay, Zainab,
just one line is there, so I want you to read it.
PPE, personal protective equipment.
Equipment. So you all of you all would have heard, you know, that the doctors and the nurses were wearing the PPE kit. Now, what is the full form of PPE? Personal protective equipment. I want one of you to repeat this. Personal protective equipment.
Personal protective equipment.
Yes, so everybody should learn this, you know, because when you are asked in a quiz or something like what is the full form of PPE, so you don't know, you know, you have heard everybody saying the doctors and the nurses and the the health warriors, you know, they were all wearing the PPE kit. Now, what is the full meaning of PPE kit? Personal protective equipment. Okay, please repeat one of you again. Personal protective equipment.
Personal protective equipment.
Yes, everybody can say one after the other. Personal protective equipment. Everybody can say one after the other.
Personal protective.
Personal. Yes, personal protective equipment. Again, somebody else. Because see, once you get over this class, you will forget this. So all of you should remember forever that you must, you know, you must know what is PPE. And somebody asks you, you shouldn't feel blank. Oh, I don't know the meaning. So it is personal protective equipment. Okay, next, Zainab, you read this. This is very easy. WFH is work from home. WFH, work from home. Okay. Now I want one more child. Zainab, call out the girl's name who's going to read this rapid test.
Fatima Tarwadi.
Fatima Tarwadi, please read this. Fatima Tarwadi, yes, please read.
Rapid test. A rapid antigen.
Antigen.
Antigens test suitable for point of care testing that directly detects the presence or absence of antigen, a toxin or other foreign substance which induce an immune response in the body, especially the production of antibodies.
Okay, so you all know that we had gone for a rapid test. Everybody had gone for a rapid test, you know, because we wanted to know whether we are affected with corona or not. So if you remember in Bhavnagar, every region, every area had one rapid test unit over there. And all of your parents would have taken the rapid test to know whether you are affected with coronavirus or not. Okay, and this rapid antigen test suitable, or so this is just if you want to know on the spot that whether you've got it or not. Now these tests are not very reliable, you know that it is not very reliable. Sometimes a person has coronavirus, is affected with coronavirus, but you know it comes negative. Sometimes it comes positive, but if it is positive, that means it is positive you are having. But some people who've got positive, who have but they get negative test, they have to go for another test. So rapid test is one which is taken on the spot. So rapid antigen test, antigen is the antibodies in our body. Test suitable for point of care testing that directly detects the presence or absence of antigen, a toxin or other foreign substance which induces or immune response in the body, especially the production of antibodies. So this is a test to know whether you have got the antibodies of coronavirus in your body. So this is a rapid test. Okay, now I want another child to read this. If you remember, we had another test that was RT-PCR. RT-PCR. Have you heard of this or not, all of y'all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So we should know the full form of this, isn't it? Now I want somebody to read this. Zainab, please call out the name.
Solanki Almas.
Yes, Almas.
Yes, ma'am.
Please read RT-PCR.
RT-PCR, reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction. The highly sensitive technique for a detection of acute infection of coronavirus. RT-PCR test analyzes DNA, the deoxynuclei.
Come on, repeat after me. Deoxynuclei. Okay.
Through a swab sample for a nose and throat to check for COVID-19 infection. DNA and espanol DNA is a chemical for a molecule that carries genetic instructions in all living things. The DNA molecule consists of two strands that winds around one another to form a shape known as double helix.
Okay, let me explain. So the full form of, you know, we all heard that I've taken the rapid test and I've come negative, but the doctor told me to take the second test, that is the RT-CPR. Okay, now the full form of RT-CPR, we must learn this: reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction. So, but just now, who was reading better? Almaz, you are reading?
Yes, ma'am.
Please repeat: reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction.
Reverse
transcription
polymers
chain reaction. Okay, so all of you must learn these words and what it means, you know. Then these are the contractions, you know, of the full form. So a highly sensitive technique for the detection of. Yes, better. Anyone is speaking? Okay, you can mute the mic better. A highly sensitive technique for the detection of the acute infection of coronavirus. So how is coronavirus can you please mute the mic? Who is speaking better? Okay, please mute the mic. A highly sensitive technique for the detection of acute infection of coronavirus. So this is another test which we can, from there we can get a confirmed result whether you have got corona, affected by coronavirus, or you're not affected. Okay, so RT-CPR test analysis DNA. Okay, the full form of DNA is deoxybonucleic acid. Now everybody, you know, if you know, no, if you have seen serials, or if you have seen stories, you have read stories, sometimes it happens, you know, you would have read in Hindi pictures especially, that see, we don't know if the baby is hers. Okay, we don't know whether she's telling the truth, okay, the baby is her or not. So to know whether the father and the mother are of the baby, they go through a DNA test. They go through a DNA test that is called deoxybonucleic acid, okay. So you say that, no, that is in her DNA. Okay, just as you say, that is in her genes, you know. We say that is in her DNA. That is, those are the genes which the parents have passed on to the child. So here, the rapid test analysis DNA through a swab sample from the nose and the throat to check for the COVID-19 infection. So if you know how the test was done, you know, they would put a cotton on cotton in the nose, you know, but they had some long straw-like thing on which the cotton was wrapped, and they put some medicine on it to test. They would just push it in the nostril, you know, and put it out fast, you know. It was, it would take 1 second, but you know, that was quite a risky thing, you know, like for those who are not comfortable, you know, and you are even chances of you start sneezing. So, yes, a swab test for the nose and the throat. So, they take two separate straw like things with cotton swabs, that is cotton wrapped around it, dipped in some medicine. And one is they put it right inside the throat and take it out immediately, because something sticks on it, the saliva or something that sticks on that, and that is sent for the test. In the same way, they take out from the nose, and again that is also taken in the test tube and sent to the laboratory to test whether you've got coronavirus or not. Okay, DNA and Espinol DNA is the chemical for the molecule that carries genetic instructions in all living things. Like just I told you, we say, no, that it is in his genes, you know. Like somebody is a very good singer, and his father is a singer, and the mother is a singer. So we say it is in his genes, it is in his DNA, okay. He is a good singer, you see, it is in his genes. The DNA molecule consists of two strands that winds around one another to form a shape known as the double helix. So, you know, what does the molecule have? There are two strands. Strands means you can thin strip, you can say thin thread like thing. Two strands that wind around, they wrap around each other and form a shape like a double helix. Okay. Now I want another girl to read this. Anomosia. Please call out the name. Yes, beta?
Ms. Bashik.
Ms. Bashik, please read it. Naini Modessa, your chance is gone. When I told you to read, you weren't there. Anyway, we'll wait for some time if we have some more words. Just now, Ms. Ba will read.
Okay. Anosmia. The loss of the
anosmia.
The loss of the sense of smell either total or
partial.
It may be caused by head injury, injection, or
infection or blockage of nose. Very good. So you know, you if all of you all now know the yellow thara with the symptoms of coronavirus. So one of the symptoms is anosmia. What is the symptom? Anosmia. Okay, that is loss of sense or smell, either total or partial. That is, sometimes you can't smell certain things, at times you can. And sometimes it is totally that you cannot, smell. So it may be caused by head injury, infection, or blockage of the nose. So you all know that during coronavirus, everyone used to get cold and cough. And, you know, we were told to sneeze in the bend of our elbow, to be very careful, to wash your hands every now and then if you put your hand over your nose. So all these are safety measures. So, why? Because the nose is the one that is, that there is going to be a blockage, you know, in the nose because of some infection. So because of the infection, or if there's a head injury, you might feel the loss of smell. Okay, you can't smell anything. So, does anyone of you all experienced this, gone through this experience during coronavirus? Anybody of you all were affected by coronavirus, or somebody in your family?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
No, ma'am. So, no one.
Okay, no one. But somebody whose parents or... Yes, so somebody has, you know, and they will say that they cannot smell anything, they cannot taste anything. But the main thing is smell. You cannot smell, you know, the strong smell of the masalas or the curry that is being cooked, or something, you know, the strong smell of something. You cannot smell. So you've learned a new word, anosmia. All of you must say anosmia, anosmia. Okay?
Yes, so we'll ma'am.
Okay, next we move on to... the cardiovascular system. Yes, Mother, so now we can read.
Yes, cardiovascular system. A group of organs that includes the heart, cardio and blood vessels, vascular. The cardiovascular system is responsible for pumping and circulating blood around the body.
Okay, so we say, you know, if you would have heard, you know, I'm doing some cardio exercises. Now, you must be wondering, what is cardio exercises? So this is, it is a cardiovascular system, a group of organs that include the heart. Okay, and the blood vessels is called vascular. So remember, something to, related to heart is cardio, and something related to blood vessel is vascular. So it is cardiovascular system. Now you know that, you know, the blood moves around the body through the different arteries and it goes to the heart, isn't it? So that's why the heart and the blood is connected. How it's connected? Because it moves, the flow of the blood is through the heart, you know, how it gets into the heart and how it is, it moves out of the heart, you know, and moves to the different parts of the body. So a group of organs that include the heart, cardio and the blood vessels is called cardiovascular system, is responsible for pumping and circulating the blood around the body. So it is a system by which the blood is sent all around, it's caused to move around the body. So you've learned in science also probably what is cardiovascular. Have you learned this in science? Yes or no? Have you learned this in science? Girls, are you there? Have you learned this in science, cardiovascular?
No, ma'am.
No, you will learn when you learn about the respiratory system or some system, okay? Or about the heart. So you remember next time, you know, that I'm doing cardio. Cardio is, I'm doing cardio exercise, that is to do with your heart, you know, all the upper part of the body, that is cardiovascular. Because it is the relation of the heart and the blood vessels, okay? Now we'll move on to the next one. Yes, who's going to read one line only?
Can I?
Yes, Zainab, please call out the girl's name.
Mariam. Mariam Saleh.
Zainab, call out. Mariam? Mariam?
Yes.
Mariam?
Yes, ma'am.
Please read this.
When a person has more than one health conditions at one. the
Madhesa, please mute your mic. Okay, it is comorbidity. Comorbidity. What is the word? Repeat after me, beta. Comorbidity. So when a person has more than one health condition of the same at the same time, for example, you know, there are certain tests. For example, you are now taking, everybody's taking vaccinations, correct? So some people, you know, they say that a person who's got comorbidity, not very effective, because the person has a lot of other problems also. For a person who has, say, coronavirus, and he also from the beginning he has blood pressure, he has diabetes, he has thyroid, he has a lot of other problems, then you say he has got comorbidity. Okay, so a person who has more than one health condition. So a person who does not have anything, you not say, but a person who has got multiple problems. For example, your grandmother has knee problem, your grandmother has cholesterol problem, your grandmother has diabetes. So you can say she is comorbidity. She has comorbidity. It's not comorbidity, but comorbidity. Okay? So remember that when a person has more than one health condition at the same time. Okay. Now, and even sometimes it is said, you know, these vaccines are very not effective for those who are suffering from comorbidity. Okay. Now, incidents. I want the next child to read. Next child.
Humaira Ganyani.
Yes, ma'am.
Please read.
Okay. Incidence refers to the number of individuals who develop a specific disease of or experience or a specific health-related event during a particular time period, such as a month of or a year.
Okay, I think somebody is speaking at the back, some small child. So, better mute your mic.
Okay.
Just muted. So, incidence refers to the number of individuals who develop a specific disease or experience a specific health-related event during a particular time period, such as a month or year. So, you can say that, you know, COVID took over an incidence of 1 year. Okay. So, we know that so many people were affected. Okay. They have developed this disease and experienced certain health problems during this whole year. You know that the 2019-20 whole year was like everybody was suffering. Mostly, majority, in every house there was one COVID patient. So you can say it is the number of incidents. Incidence refers to number of individuals who develop a specific disease. So you can say this incidence of coronavirus was, there in the year 2020. Now we'll move on to the next child, because we have to complete better. I think one, let me see how many words are there. Okay. So we'll continue the next one. Remember, now we have to go to mucormycosis, previously called zygomycosis. All of this is related to science, but this is something that you have to understand. What is black fungus? What is white fungus? What is yellow fungus and symptoms? Why? Because this has been prevalent in the last whole year. And we should be aware of all the terms that are related to corona. Okay, so I know, girls, that y'all can see the video and write down everything in your communicative English book. Okay, and please try to remember the new words that you all have learned. Thank you, children. Thank you. Have a good day. Stay safe at home.
Bye, ma'am. Bye,
ma'am. Have a nice
day. Bye, better. Bye.
Bye. Have a wonderful day.
Bye,
bye,
better.
Ma'am.
Bye, better. You also have a nice day. Chalo, bye, all of you.
Bye, ma'am.